How to use the Rapid Response Strep A Rapid Test Device. Humidity and temperature can affect results. Do not use after the expiration date printed on the back of the pouch. Do not use the test if the foil pouch is damaged. Bring the test to room temperature before use. Your kit will include test cassettes or strips in individually sealed pouches, one bottle of reagent 1, one bottle of reagent 2, one negative control, one positive control, sterilized swabs, nozzles with filter, extraction tubes, a tube stand, and the product insert. Materials required but not provided, timer. Read the instructions carefully before you begin. Protective gloves should be worn when handling the specimen. Place the desired number of extraction tubes in the tube stand. Add 4 drops of reagent 1 to the extraction tube. And then add 4 drops of reagent 2. Mix the solution gently by swirling the extraction tube. Set the extraction solution aside and collect a specimen sample. Remove the sterile swab from its packaging. All specimens should be treated as potentially infectious. Protective gloves should be worn when handling the specimen. Have the patient open their mouth as wide as possible. Direct the tip of the swab toward the tonsillar area. Do not touch the swab tip to any other area of the mouth, including the tongue. Rub the swab tip quickly and firmly over the tonsillar area to collect the throat swab. Remove the swab from the mouth. Avoid touching any surface with the swab. Immerse the swab into the extraction tube. Use a circular motion to roll the swab against the side of the extraction tube. Let stand for 1 to 2 minutes at room temperature. After 1 to 2 minutes, squeeze the swab firmly against the tube to expel as much liquid as possible. Discard the swab. For cassettes, attach the nozzle onto the extraction tube. For strips, do not attach the nozzle onto the extraction tube. Remove the cassette from its sealed pouch. Place the test device on a non-absorbent, clean and level surface. Optionally, label the device. Add 3 drops of the extracted solution onto the sample region of the test device. Avoid trapping air bubbles in the specimen region, and do not add any solution to the results region. After adding the solution onto the test device, start a 5-minute timer. 4 test strips. Remove the test strip from its sealed pouch, holding the colored end. Do not touch the white section of the strip. Dip the test strip into the sample solution, immersing the test strip. Do not dip the strip past the solid max line. Wait for 1 minute. After 1 minute, remove the test strip from the tube and place it on a non-absorbent, clean and flat surface. Start a 5-minute timer. Read the test results between 5 to 10 minutes. Do not read results earlier than 5 minutes or later than 10 minutes. Interpretation of results. Positive results. 2 colored bands appear on the membrane. One band appears in the control region, C, and another band appears in the test region, T. Note, the intensity of color in the test region, T, may vary depending on the concentration of analytes present in the specimen. Therefore, any shade of color in the test region should be considered positive. Note that this is a qualitative test only and cannot determine the concentration of analytes in the specimen. Insufficient specimen volume, incorrect operating procedure, or expired tests are the most likely reasons for control band failure. Negative results. Only one colored band appears in the control region, C. No apparent colored band appears in the test region T. Invalid results. The control band fails to appear. Results from any test which has not produced a control band at the specified read time must be discarded. Please review the procedure and repeat with the new test. If the problem persists, discontinue using the kit immediately and contact your local distributor. After you have finished testing, dispose of all used test materials in the trash.